sound of the waves crashing as you sit on the balcony of the lavish villa with a glass of Sambuca in your hand, overviewing the green of the garden, the magnificent resort right beside the warm and sunny beach. Heavenly, right? But do you know about the damage these structures cause to our coastal habitats? Anthropogenic activities and rising sea levels threaten our coastal environment, which constitutes 40% of the Indian population. To protect our coastal environment and improve the lives of coastal communities, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, issued the Coastal Regulation Zone notification in 1991, which is a set of rules to regulate human and industrial activities close to the coast in order to shield the fragile ecosystems near the sea. Over the last 29 years, the notification has been iterated twice and modified 34 times, making it the most amended law in Indian history. Let us see what is so important about it. The entire 6,068 km long mainland coast of the country has been classified into four categories, setting up the rules and regulations for each. CRZ1, which includes areas that are environmentally most critical, including areas like mangroves, coral reefs, and the area between low tide line and high tide line. The CRZ2 constitutes the areas that have already been developed up to or close to the shoreline, which is already substantially built up, provided with drainage, approach roads, and other infrastructural facilities. CRZ3 constitutes relatively undisturbed rural land areas, which limits the no development zone landwards till 50 to 200 meters from high tide lines. Finally, CRZ4, which constitutes the water areas from the low tide line up to 12 nautical miles on the seaward side as well, between LTL of both banks, of estuaries and rivers. For protection of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep, a separate notification has been issued. The CRZ notification aims to conserve our coasts and promote sustainability. However, the 2019 proposal aims at relaxing the increase in commercialization. Our coasts are facing high vulnerability, and the relaxation in such laws can lead to immense exploitation and destruction of these sensitive environments. But why do we need to know this? It is our responsibility as consumers who drive the commercialization to know about the effect of our choices on the coastal regions, which shall help us ultimately to make better choices for the environment. Thus, we should educate ourselves to be mere admirers, leaving nothing but footprints behind.